discussing the FileMaker 17 Starter Solutions. The Starter Solutions are here for you to start your journey in developing your dream application. Now, as you can see, there are 6 Starter Solutions to select from. Assets, Contacts, Content Management, Inventory, Meetings, and Task. Now, Assets and Meetings are brand new to the FileMaker 17 Starter Solutions. The other 4 have been the previous versions, so those are some of the new additions to the Starter Solutions. Along with the six Starter Solutions, there are 16 sample solutions, which are more advanced than the Starter Solutions. So to begin kind of going over the Starter Solutions, which is what we're going to be focusing on, some of the main changes of the Starter Solutions are that starting out there are 2 new ones, like I stated earlier, and also that they are now been changed to the Universal Touch theme. And they've been changed to the Universal Touch theme because of a variety of styles can be used on it and easily combined with the different styles in that same layout for the Starter Solutions. Also, with the Starter Solutions, they're not installed on the go. Only four of the sample solutions are installed on FileMaker Go, which you can get on your iPad and iPhone for free. And those 4 sample solutions are Contacts, Event Management, Invoices, and Projects. And to modify those, you have to go to the FileMaker Go solutions and email to your desktop and make the changes on your desktop with FileMaker Pro Advanced. Now, to get started in creating a new application with the Starter Solution, you need to open up your FileMaker application and then go to File and Create New. And the Create New will open the Starter Solutions menu. And this is what we have opened here. Now, to start off, we'll be looking at Assets as the first Starter Solution we go through. Now, here is the Assets. Now, with the purpose of the Assets Starter Solution is to track office assets, see what the assets are purchased, and who is using those assets. And as you can see from the if you've used the previous Starter Solutions, the Universal Touch theme has changed the layout and the look of it. With the new Universal Touch theme, you will see that up here, you will have the name, the type, purchase date, and price, and use by information up there. And that is primarily used to make it easier to search for a specific asset instead of having to digging through everything. And you can see that will pop up when we type in the information into the Starter Solution. And as you can see, as you put it in, it pops up. And with this information up top, you'll see that it's easier to identify what the asset is and what instead of having to digging around. Now, next, we're going to move on to Contacts. And the Contacts is designed to manage the personal and business contact information for several individuals. So as you can see, like with the assets before, and this is comes with the Universal Touch theme, the information is put up at the top, but for contacts, only the name and the company is put up at the top, just so you can identify who the person is and the company. And having that company there makes it easier to identify when people have the same last name, same name, and are different companies. That way you know who's who. And with the solution, you can also select titles as well, and they give these options. And you can select from them and also choose other. And as you put the name in, it pops up at the top. And you can also put a job title so you can identify what they are and who they are more in depth. And here to the right, you'll see that you have the options to put the company name, which will, along with the website, which will pop up down here. And here you can put in the phone number along with the type of phone, whether it's home, mobile, or work. And same goes for email. You can type what kind of email it is for them, along with the address as well. And with that, we'll move forward onto the content management starter solution. Now, the content management solution is used for collecting and organizing documents, images, music, and many more things. And with that, you have the option to just type in what kind of file or whatever you're looking to do work with and keep track of. So it can just be music. Maybe office music. And when you go to the type, you have the options to choose from photo, image, PDF, audio, video, office, web, all those options to go for. And also you get the option to choose status to see where that is. Is it being worked on, completed, has been archived? You get all these options here to select from that are already installed into the starter solution for you to use. And with that, you get, with that information being put in, you do see the information appear at the top as well, just as before, a part of being on the Universal Touch theme. And next, we will go into inventory. Now, the inventory starter solution is used to manage inventory levels of products and supplies, along with tracking the part numbers, transaction history, and much more. Now, as you can see, when you put in the information, it'll appear at the top, but over here on the right, you'll have the tabs to make it easier to access instead of having to like scroll up and down and dig around looking for the specific information. And you can put this information in. But here you can, for the part, but when you go to the cost, you can put the unit cost, then the unit price, and you also have the option of making it taxable. But as you can see, when you don't have the option on the cost tab to put in the units on hand, and to do that, you need to go to the stock tab, and you'll be able to do that right here, where it says units, and just put in the amount of units you want, and also have the option of having it as in stock or out of stock. And as you can see, when that's changed, down here, it gets changed as well. So once it's in stock, it lets you know right here down at the bottom that this product or part is in stock or out of stock. And when you go back to the cost here, you'll see that the 20 gets put in there and also is calculated to find the stock value that you have. So that's it for the inventory starter solution. Next, we'll be going into the meetings starter solution, which this is the other new one with assets. So with the meeting starter solution, this is used to track meetings along with setting an agenda topics and assigning action items for each meeting. And you can do that by plugging in the information here. And as you put this information in, you will see that date is put on, and also you can put in the time for the duration of the meeting. Oh, and that will also appear below here to show how long this meeting should last. And now with the notes, you can put in the notes of anything you want for your meeting, whether it's notes during the meeting or anything prior to the meeting, along with topics that you want to cover during the meeting, and you can add multiple topics as well with little descriptions as add it on into those. And as you put multiple topics in, you'll see that the number of topics will appear up here and display for anyone to see. And just by clicking out of it, it does add a new topic selection. And as you can see, The 2 comes out here for the amount of topics that you do have. And with the action items, it's the same thing as you put in the information. It does appear up here. And you can select just when the due date is for those action items and also the status as well, whether if it's an open issue, high level, miscellaneous, or closed. And that is it for the meetings, starter solution. And then for the final starter solution is the task. And now the task, the starter solution can be used to track tasks and the priority of those tasks and the status and the due dates of all those. And also you can add as many assignees to those tasks as you wish. So right here you can see that you can choose whether what kind of task this is for. And the priority of it is high, medium, or low. And also the status of this. And you can also put right here when the task is completed. That way anybody can look and know when it was completed just so they have reference to that. Now when assigning someone to a task, you go down here to this plus, and this little box will pop up, and you go to the right corner and press that plus sign again to input that information. And you can only put their name and email on there. And you can add multiple people to a task as well, not just one, so that gives you that flexibility there. Now, you can also add attachments to those tasks that are needed or have been worked on for anyone to view for that specific task as well. You can do that by adding on anywhere. So that wraps up the 6 starter solutions. You can use these starter solutions to begin developing your dream application. But if these 6 starter solutions are not what you're looking for, you can always check out the 16 sample solutions as well, with more options as they are more advanced. And if that's not what you're looking for, we also have our own template you can look at. That is the FM Quickstart, and it is a free download and has been optimized to run on the latest version of FileMaker. And if you're interested in learning more about the FileMaker 17 platform, I recommend going to our website and looking at the FileMaker 17 overview article to kind of have a good understanding of what comes with FileMaker 17. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I enjoyed presenting these 6 starter solutions, and I can't wait to see what you guys develop. Thanks.